number 10 today. Tapocha Brahmacharya. Ariya Satchana Dasana. Nibbana Satchikiriya. Esam Mangala Muttama. I have told you, it started at home by doing our duties and fulfilling our responsibilities as religious way of life, and step by step we continue developing and developing and developing and developing. Now we have come nearer to Four Noble Truths, Eight Noble Paths and Nirvana. Very systematically the Buddha has introduced this Mangala Sutta. Without neglecting all our duties, responsibilities, our work, and then our virtues, our precepts, and mental development, then slowly, slowly continue. Now this one, tapoja, tapas, self-control. In English we say self-control. The word self usually people use for Atma or soul. Here different means. Like you yourself are here, there is no soul there. You yourself. Here meaning you must know how to control yourself. It is not your soul, but you have to develop yourself. How to develop? What sort of development we are going to discuss here? Not the material or worldly or sensual. Now this is the real development of our mind. We have knowledge, we have intelligence, but very few people have development. Development is not the knowledge. Person can study everything in this world, wonderful knowledge, but still there is no mental development. Because that person can be very jealous, very hot-tempered. They have nothing to do with that knowledge. Development means by knowing the weaknesses in our mind and cultivate the good thoughts. That is called development. Now religion, I think I have told you so many times, English word religion, it is a Latin word religio, binding meaning, but when they introduced this as religion, they interpreted binding to God. So Buddhism cannot agree with that. Buddha says to liberate from human and divine bondages, not to bind. Are there the difference? When somebody dies, you can see how they advertise in the newspaper. When Hindus die, they say, union with Brahma. Brahma is the creator God. So he going to be with him. That is the Christian, to be with Lord. People like this word. That means going to be with Lord. That is the. Now Buddhist cannot say to be with Buddha. It is wrong. But we think in that way, because of the worldly way of thinking about life. Liberate, deliverance freedom from all worldly and divine bondages also. We have divine bondages. They are for our worldly power and protections and pleasure, but development of the mind never takes place with them. Development takes place. Let us take the word education. Same meaning, education. Also Latin words. Edico. Edico means development. When they introduce this education, they confine to academic knowledge. Worldly knowledge, book knowledge, academic knowledge. Education. But the real meaning of the word is development of the mind. But today, no development. More jealousy, more anger, more greed, we develop. The more we learn, the more we develop these bad qualities also. That is not education. In Sanskrit language, also they use the word vidya. That is very meaningful. They define the word vidya dadati vinaya. Vidya, education. Education gives vinaya. Vinaya means discipline. Education discipline us. There's a very deep meaning in that word, discipline. Physically, mentally, verbally, we learn how to discipline ourselves. That is education. Also not academic knowledge. There are so many things for us to learn from our childhood. How to discipline ourselves. If we really practice, each and every person can live peacefully. Because we have discipline. So in the modern education, there is no discipline. We have knowledge, scientific knowledge, worldly knowledge, but no discipline. What is discipline? Vidya dadati vinayam, vinayadveti patrata. That is in Sanskrit language. Because of this discipline, everybody welcomes. Vinayadreti pasrata. Having seen our behavior, our attitude, our way of life, everybody welcome, respect us. That is education. After that, pasratan dhanamanvayati. Then, we gain everything what we need, started from discipline. Discipline appreciated by the society, welcome, support, assist, not to harm, not to discriminate, not to condemn. And then we gain what we need. That is education. Here this word, support also, self-discipline, means we must know what are the weaknesses in our mind. All of us have. No one is free. But when we are normal, others cannot understand. When anybody irritates, provokes, create temptation, then we can find out how those things flare up. Now we are normal, therefore we cannot see. Now we cannot see anger in your mind, but anger is there. If somebody irritates you, provoke you, disturb you, then that hidden anger flare up. By knowing this, jealousy, anger, greed, selfishness, impatience, intolerance, we try to control it. Train the mind not to allow those evil forces to be active. Then develop. Mind is controlling us without allowing to make use of those evil thoughts that we have in our mind. That is not enough. Development of kindness, compassion, sympathy, honesty, patience, tolerance, then development. That is called development. But people are educated, but we cannot find these good qualities in their mind. So there is no development. So suppose, so when we develop our mind without allowing evil thoughts to be active, by controlling them, cultivate good thoughts. That we call self-discipline. Suppose. You know the word tapasa. Tapasa means those who give up worldly way of life, devote or dedicate their life for religious way of life. They are called tapasa. Tapa, same word, tapos. The other one is brahmachari. What is the meaning given here? Very simple language. It is written pure life. Usually people say brahmachari means righteous way of life. Righteous way of life means respectable life. Respectable life means noble life. That's called brahmacharya. There is another meaning. Those who observe 8 precepts, 10 precepts, there's one particular precept of brahmacharya. Veramani sikkhapadam samma. That is another meaning. Another meaning means behave like Brahma, a brahmacharya. Behave like Brahma. Why? Why we say behave like Brahma? Brahma have no sex formation. They are free from male or female. So behave like Brahma. As I call brahmacharya. That problem is no more, not in the mind, to disturb. Behave like Brahma. Suppose a brahmacharya. Then, Arya Satchana Darsana. Arya means noble. Arya Mahasangha means holy, arahant. The monk, Arya Sangha. The word Arya we use for the holy, Arahant. Here Arya Satcha Dasana, perceptions of the noble truth. Perception. Try to understand the noble truth. Truth and noble truth. Two kinds of truths are there. Noble truth can go on changing from time to time according to circumstances, that truth change. Therefore, it is not noble truth. Noble truth means the truth that you never change. Again, one who tries to understand this truth also become a noble person. Noble truth. So one who tries to understand this noble truth also become a noble person. Chattari Arya Satyani. Four noble truths. The most difficult truth for us to understand. Because of our imagination and worldly mindedness, difficult to understand the real meaning of Four Noble Truths. We know the words, we know the meaning, but realization is very difficult. What are those four noble truths? Dukkha, Samudaya, Nirodha, Mama. Four. You know the meanings also. What is Dukkha? What is Dukkha? You say suffering, not only suffering, there are many things. Dukkha. Then, unsatisfactoriness is the word people use nowadays, not suffering. Dukkha. Nirodha, no, Samudaya, the cause of suffering. You must understand the cause. Why? Why we suffer? We give some other reasons, but that is not the cause. Nirodha, liberation from dukkha, samudaya. Samudaya means get rid of samudaya. Magga, marga or magga, meaning the way, the method that we had to practice to understand dukkha, samudaya, nirodha. What is that manga, marga, or way, or method? Eight Noble Paths. Without going through Eight Noble Paths, we cannot get into this. Eight Noble Paths in simple language introduced as middle path, noble path of religious way, Buddhist way of life and way to Nibbana. Eight Noble Paths. Dr. Rich David, who started Pali Text Society in London, to translate Pali Buddhist book into English. He was the son of a Christian priest. When he was in Sri Lanka, during the British period, he heard many people appreciate Buddhism. He wanted to know why people appreciate Buddhism. So he wanted to study Buddhism to find out the weaknesses, main purpose. But not enough English book, more than 100 years ago. Not enough English book. So, the teachings of the Buddha were written in Pali language. So he decided to learn Pali. There was only one Buddhist monk in Sri Lanka at that time, who could manage to preach or teach in English. Only one. So he approached this monk can study Pali, very intelligent man. And his wife also joined with him, both of them studied Pali, learned, proper. Then, when they returned to London, they decided to form this Pali Text Society to translate the Tripitaka teachings of the Buddha into English. They started translating. There many books have translated and printed, but still they are doing it, continuing. Then he has written, "I have learned all the existing religions in this world, but I could not find out Four Noble Truths and Eight Noble Paths in any other religion, only in the teachings of the Buddha." Again he has written, "The main purpose why I wanted to study Buddhism, to find out the weaknesses so that I can compare with Christianity, then what happened to me? After learning Buddhism, without my knowledge, I have become a Buddhist." He never had the idea of becoming a Buddhist, but want to find out the weaknesses. But after learning, it is so convincing, he become a Buddhist. And his wife also followed. After his death, the wife continued translating. So, he said, Four Noble Truths and Eight Noble Paths he has never seen in any other religion. Then what are those four in simple language? Dukkha, we say unsatisfactoriness. Throughout our life, every minute we get some sort of unsatisfactory. Whatever we gain, we cannot keep or satisfy for long, short, after short period, unsatisfactory. Anything, at the beginning very pleasant, very soothing, very attractive, but later, unsatisfactory. Anything what we gain, then conflict, clashes, dukkha. Conflict means, let us take this body, combinations of elements and energy. Friction always takes place. Elements and elements and energies and elements. That is why physically and mentally we feel very uneasiness and pain and sufferings and aches and worries. It is natural. But we have our own imagination. We think maybe charms or black magic or what you call certain other things, our imagination. These are natural occurrences. Let us take this earth, friction and clatter, earthquake, volcanic eruption, all over the world. Let us take plant life, also face the same problem. Sicknesses, decaying and dying. Even plant life, dukkha is there. So, every minute we are experiencing some sort of uneasiness, physically and wealthy. God has nothing to do with that. The Buddha has nothing to do with this. These are the natural occurrences. Teachings of the Buddha is called dharma. Why? Since Buddha has explained how these natural occurrences take place, or his teaching is called dharma. All the other religions talk about God or devil. The Buddha never referred to them. All these are natural occurrences. No one can stop this by praying and worshipping and doing all sorts of things. No. No one can stop. Natural occurrences. Let us take a life. A baby is being born. After few months we can see this baby is growing, growing, growing. After few years time, then 7, 8, 10, 15, 20, up to 40. Go on growing, 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 growing. That is dharma. There is no God behind that. Nobody to handle that. That is the universal law. Natural occurrence. After growing, growing up to that level, then turn into this way. Then 60, 70, 80, going down and down and down and down. Natural, that is dharma. Natural occurrence. This is the nature of all these elements and energies combined together, remain as a bundle. Then go on changing, changing, decaying, decaying and dissolving. That is dharma. It is natural. We cannot stop all these things by praying to anybody. That is dukkha. So how many people can understand this? They create their own imagination. Dukkha. Next one, samudaya. What is the cause of this unpleasant or unsatisfactory? Our craving. We never think. If there is no craving, there is no unsatisfactoriness, unhappiness, disappointment, worry, fear, never appear in our mind. Therefore, the main cause of all our physical and mental sufferings are due to our craving. The very day when this craving is completely eradicated from the mind, nirvana. Nir means no, vana means craving, no more craving, then we are in nirvana. By keeping our craving, we never experience nirvana in this. But all the other religions teach us, God is there, your soul will be there, and you exist there with the God. Develop the craving. But here in the teachings of the Buddha, says you reduce and reduce and reduce your craving, then you will be free from all your sufferings and craving and fear and worries and disturbances and enmity and anger and jealousy. Completely free. So we are doing so many bad, wicked, cruel, harmful, shameful things because of our craving. If there is no craving, we never do all these things. but not so easy to get rid of this craving. So the Buddha has introduced this systematically, practically, how to do that. First, you have to stop craving towards others' belonging, others' property. That is the beginning. You should not crave for others' property. You satisfy with your own property. That is the beginning. Later, you will come to know lots of troubles and problems and difficulties, calamities you have to face just because you have craving towards your property. You have fear, you have suspicion, you have worries, you have to take precaution, others may come and bluff you, cheat you, steal, because you have craving towards your property. These are the reasons. You can enjoy your life by using your own property, there's nothing wrong. But the craving that you maintain towards your property definitely gives lot of problems and troubles and disturbances. Then you have to train your mind to maintain contentment. Step by step we are marching. What is contentment? This is enough for me. This is enough for my family. Then you reduce a lot of your craving. You satisfy, this is enough for me. Now, jealousy never appears in your mind. Because you are satisfied. When others enjoy their life, naturally jealousy appears in our mind. Now, if contentment is there in our mind, no jealousy. If no jealousy, no anger. If no anger, no violence. We'll be free from all these things through this contentment. You can satisfy. You can sleep peacefully. You have no worries in your mind. Now, reducing. Then, all your belonging, what you have that you can satisfy as mine, you cannot keep with you forever. When the time comes for us to depart from this world, we have to release our minds, our attachment towards our property. Otherwise, disturbances in the mind. You have to hand over or donate your children or anybody who's entitled. Then your mind is free. Now no craving, no attachment in your mind. Release. Then we can depart from this world without fear, without worries, without suspicion, without insecurity, without confusion. Many people die with one of these things. Very few people get the chance to die with free mind. Mind must be free from all these things. Because we cannot carry anything. And then, how far we have developed this? Not to crave, step by reducing. Now we have craving towards our physical body. my body. This is not my body, not belong to me. I am living in this body. I means life. Life is living in this body. This is the house. So I crave for this as my body. Then I can do any wicked, any cruel, any harmful, any dangerous things to protect my body, protect my life, because of that craving. So much of craving to it. There are previous birth stories of the Buddha. How he sacrificed his life for the well-being of others, to release others. They are very happy to do that. Instead of harming others to protect our body, we can develop our mind to sacrifice the whole life to release others from their suffering. That is one aspect of dana, paramita. Dana in three ways. Material thing, food and clothing and money and anything. Very easy, anyone can do that. But that is not enough. We had to reduce craving towards our organs. Today, they develop. There are so many organs in our body that we can contribute, donate for the well-being of others, to protect others' life. Blood, eyes, heart, kidneys, many things. So we have to donate whatever we can from our body. Many people have superstitious beliefs, lots of superstitions. They say, if one of these organs is taken away from our body, in the next life we will be born without that. See how narrow our understanding. It's scary. Do you know Albert Einstein? He died 48 years ago. One of the best intellectual scientists. He said, after my death, please take away my brain and study. They have done that. Still they are studying his brain. So far they have discovered two places in his brain, extraordinary formation that they have not seen any other brain. So Albert Einstein's rebirth has taken place without brain, because brain is here. See how narrow actually our thinking. And there are some people who believe they cannot take blood from the followers of another religion. They think religion is there in the blood. They cannot take kidney or heart from the followers of another religion. Where is religion in the kidney or in the heart? See how narrow their way of thinking. So, I have been talking about the craving for this physical body, how to reduce. For our meditation, the Buddha has introduced four methods. In Satipatthana Sutra, Kaya Kayanupasti Vedanasu Vedananupatti, Chitte Chittanupatti, Dhammesu Dhammanupatti. Four. Kaya, Vedana, Chitta, Dhamma. Four items. Four, concentration, meditation. The first item is Kaya. Kaya means body. Either my body or your body. I take as an object for my meditation. Then the whole body divides into 32 parts. Now all together as a bundle. We can separate into 32 parts. Start from hair, a skin, flesh, bones, then go on item by item, all together 32. We analyze this body, then concentrate. When we separate it into 32 groups, that person is missing. He is not there. When all these things join together, the person again appears. That means the person is concept created in our mind. But when you separated all the organs and everything, no person, nobody. This understanding appears in our mind. Then, Vedana, feeling, pleasant, unpleasant. When unpleasant ache and pain come to us, we hate. Hatred is hated. Whether you hate for yourself or for another person, makes no difference. You pollute your own mind. So instead of hating, you have to concentrate on your pain. Pain and pain and pain and pain. Get used to mind without hating. Then slowly you may forget your pain. Because you harmonize your mind with the pain, without hating. When the pleasant feeling comes, or you feel very happy, but you never think, this pleasant feeling won't last long. This may disappear very soon. If you concentrate in that way, when your pleasant feeling disappears, you do not worry, you do not complain. You knew this will disappear. What sort of pleasant feeling you are experiencing now? Impermanent, disappear very soon. Then we do not disturb the mind. It is meditation. Chitte chittanupatti. Chitta means mind. You have to concentrate on your mind. Awareness of the nature of your mind. You do not know what is happening in your mind. You know what is happening all over the world through your television. But you do know what is happening in your mind. Then you have to concentrate, introspect. I have jealousy, I have anger, I have greed, I have enmity, I have suspicion, I have insecurity feeling. Then you come to know all these things are there. These are not good things. These things can create a lot of troubles and problems and disturbances. Knowing that, we try to develop kindness, compassion, sympathy, honesty, patience, tolerance. Now you are dealing with your mind. You adjust, you correct your mind. That is meditation. Dhammesu dhammanupasti. Just now I mentioned dharma means natural phenomena, natural occurrences, universal law. When all these things, changes take place, if we have developed our mind through meditation, all these existing things are like this. This earth, this world, this sun and the moon and galaxies, or living beings, or plant life, or anything that exists, subjected to change, to decay and disappear. That is called Dhammanupasana. Then purity, understanding, confidence develop in the mind. Now understanding of this Four Noble Truths, Dukkha, Samudaya, and we understood our craving is the cause of all these problems. The more we reduce and reduce and reduce and maintain contentment, we feel very free. Freedom, liberty, simple, humble life. Then, Nirodha, freedom from craving and suffering, unsatisfactoriness, disturbances, worries, fear. Because of we have done earlier, by reducing these things, we experience very pleasant, very soothing, very confident, very peaceful life. Otherwise, we never gain this from others. We never get this from the Buddha, from God, or from anybody. We had to develop and create. The Buddha has taught us how to do that. Samudra. Last one. Marga, way. The method that we have to practice to reach, to attain, to experience Nibbanic bliss, Eight Noble Path. Without practicing, following this Eight Noble Path, by organizing rites and rituals and ceremonies and worshipping and praying and offerings and celebrations, the real noble path is not there. What are those eight items? Sammadithi, sammasankappa, sammavacha, sammakammanta, sammajiva, sammavayama, sammasati, sammasamadhi. Step by step, we have to develop and develop and develop and develop. Then we will be landed in our final goal. Let me see. Eighth Noble Path, Sammadithi. The Buddha started his mission with understanding. Remember this. No belief. He never encouraged anybody to believe anything. We believe when we cannot understand. We use the word belief. Let us say, I believe that I have met you some time ago. I believe. I believe means I am not sure. If I know that I met you, I never say I believe. So the word belief we use for the thing which we cannot understand. I believe. I can say I believe in God because I do not know whether God exists or not. Therefore, I can say I believe. But I never say I believe in the Buddha. Nothing for me to believe because I know about the Buddha. So Buddha started his mission with understand. Try to understand first within your capacity. With this understanding you have to continue. Sammadhi. Sammasankappa. As I mentioned earlier, try to understand what is happening in your mind. How evil thoughts disturb you, how good thoughts support you. How evil thoughts disturb others, how good thoughts support others. Concentrate. Then you know how to adjust, how to handle your mind. Sammasanga. Samma vacha. Vacha means talking. Art of talking. Gentle way of talking. That is very important. One word is enough to create a lot of violence and disturbance. Like bullets. Therefore, when we talk, we have to concentrate. We have to talk mindfully. What we talk, to whom I am talking, whether it is suitable for me to talk this. People go on talking, all sorts of rubbish and create lots of disturbances, calamities, enmity. Therefore, we have to talk mindfully. In the teachings of the Buddha, it is mentioned. Whether it is advisable to reveal everything that I know, the Buddha says no. When it is necessary, when it is important, you can reveal. Otherwise, don't try to reveal everything that you know. Then you know how to guard your tongue. Four methods mentioned there. Musavata, Asunavata, Purisavata, Sampappala. Four mistakes that we are doing by talking. Musavata, telling lies. I have told you, only human being knows how to tell lies. Others do not know. Why? Can you tell me the reason why others can, they have their own language, all the other living beings, but they do not know how to tell a lie. I have explained to you, I don't know that you can remember. What is the reason? We have a mind where we can find intelligence. This intelligence we cannot find in other living beings, human intelligence. So we can tell lies because of that intelligence by twisting and turning. Others do not know how to do it. That's why we have to guard. Small children also do not know how to tell lies. There's a certain age that they take, for instance, when telephone is ringing, the child goes to a telephone and say hello. Then say, can I speak to your daddy? Then they say, daddy, telephone call. Tell I am not at home. Daddy says, he is not at home. Because that innocent child doesn't know how to tell that lie. So, other living beings do not know how to tell lies. That is why we have to guard our tongue. Parasavata, Pishunavata, carrying tail. Others do not know how to do that. But we go and tell so and so, you know, so and so said like this, he criticized you, he condemned you, he accused you, he blamed you, and create enmity. We are doing this. Then third one, parusavat, vulgar, wicked, cruel word that we use to abuse, insult, blame, others. You have to guard our tongue. Then, when we talk useless things. No meaning, not useful, never support others or never support ourselves. Just go on talking. The Buddha's advice. Dhammena va samichi kattham, aryena va sunhi bhavena. Advice. If you want to talk, talk something meaningful, useful. If you haven't got any meaningful, useful idea to talk, observe golden silence. Advice given by me. So, try to avoid these four things mentioned by the Buddha, not to tell lies, not to carry tears, not to use harsh, wicked, vulgar words, not to talk rubbish. Then you are developing your noble path. Samma vacha. Samma kammanta. Kammanta means your work, your business, or your earning. You should not do your business or should not do anything for your pleasure by violating, hurting, bluffing, cheating, disturbing others. That is called samma kammanta, right action. We can do many things, but we must know how to do in gentle way. Without harming, bluffing, cheating, disturbing others. Then, noble path. Samma kamman, samma ajiva. Right livelihood. Our business. Business means trade. There are five things mentioned by the Buddha that not advisable for us to do if we want to follow the noble path. Five things, people rear animals to sell for slaughtering, cows and pigs and chickens and ducks and goats. They can make lot of money, but that is against the noble path. You can make money. Then dealing with poison, dealing with dangerous weapons. Even today you can sell suicide bomb also, you can sell, if you know how to make. And not to practice slavery. Slavery was very common business in those days. They catch poor people, bring them in the market, people buy them. Take them home and work as slaves forever. In America, those black people who were taken there as slaves. Abraham Lincoln wanted to release them. He was shot dead because of that. It's a very big business. But still going on. They take away children, take away young girls, sell to others to carry to some other countries. That is slavery. You can make money, but that is far away from the noble way of life. Then, samma vayama, right effort, not physical, mental. When anger appears in your mind, you have to develop your courage to bring without allowing this anger to flare up and disturb. Control this anger effort. When you are jealous, try to reduce this jealousy, thinking, what do we gain by developing this jealousy? Create bad atmosphere, create enemies. Reduce this jealousy. That use your effort, energy. You are very greedy. You never give anything to anybody. You enjoy yourself. Develop your energy to understand it is wrong. contribute something for the well-being of others also. That is right effort. Samma ditti, samma sankappa, samma vacha, samma kammanta, samma ajiva, samma vayama, samma sati. You can say samma mati also. Samma mati means die peacefully. Here samma sati means mindfulness. What is mindfulness? Whenever you do something, you have to fix your mind only toward that particular object. Don't allow some other thoughts to appear. Don't think something else in your mind at that time. Concentrate only on this. You have to train and train and train your mind. Anything whatever you do, not only religious work. You train your mind not to mix up with so many other thoughts. Only one thought at a time. Then you can do your work with accuracy, without making mistakes. Samma. Last one is Samma Samadhi. Right concentration. That is meditation. Meditation means we take an object and analyze, try to understand what it is in reality, without imagination, without wrong concept, wrong idea. Try to understand exactly what it is. Then the development takes place in the mind. Then purity, understanding, everything completed. That is enough. All the other activities are not important. This is more than enough. Try to understand Four Noble Truths. Try to practice Eight Noble Paths. Without spending even $1, you can do all these things. Only two lines. Prapocha, Brahmacharyacha, Arya Satchana Satana. Nibbana Satya Kriya. Now here, when we have completed all these things, realizations of Nibbana. All the other activities are not important for them. We experience Nibbanic wisdom. Puttasya loka dhammehi chittam yasra nakampati asokam virajam hemam etan mangala muttamam. Eight worldly conditions always disturb our mind. So we have to train our mind for not to disturb those eight worldly conditions and take place. What are those eight? Labho, alabho, ayaso, yaso, ninda, pasansa, sukhan, dukkha. Eight. These eight things always going round and round and round and round. Nobody in this world who can live without facing these changes. So if we know how to maintain our mental energy, without allowing them to disturb our mind, we have reached the final goal. Labho, our gain, our income. When you gain some income, we feel very happy. Labho, when we lost valuable things, we worry, we cry, we cannot sleep, we disturb the mind. Because we have lost something. But these are natural occurrences forever in this world. Everybody has to face. Sometimes you gain, sometimes you lose. You have to train the mind to face both without disturbing the mind. Labho alabho. Ayaso yasoja. Fame and ill fame. We have to face. We are not perfect. People appreciate people, condemn our life, whether we are good or bad. Some people praise, appreciate. Some others condemn and accuse. We must train ourselves not to disturb our mind. The Buddha has said to his disciples, sometimes people come and accuse, blame, criticize, condemn Buddha, Dhamma, Sangha. So when they condemn, accuse, blame, criticize, you should not get angry. Some others come and appreciate and praise and respect, you should not overjoy. Just because they praise, appreciate, maintain your normal mind. See, the Buddha is speaking. In the same manner, when we have to face them, don't show your sour face, don't get angry, don't worry. Think these are natural occurrences. Labho, alabho, ayato, yato. Ninda, pasanta. Some people condemn, accuse, blame you. Ninda. Pasansa, some people appreciate, praise. Even the Buddha, Jesus, Muhammad, any religious teacher also. Some people condemned, some people were killed, and some people worshipped, appreciated. It is natural. No one is free from this. Again, Buddha says, Natthi loke anindito. You cannot find any single human being in this world who is not abused or blamed. The Buddha was blamed, accused. What about others? So when others blame and accuse, when others praise and appreciate, you must know how to maintain balance in your mind. Ninda pasanta. Sukhancha dukkha. Sukha and dukkha. These two words you can understand. When you have pleasant, pleasurable feeling, sukha, oh, you feel very happy. Dukkha, when unpleasant, unhappy, painful occurrences take place, you worry, you cry, you grumble, you complain. You must have strong mind to face all these eight worldly conditions. When you develop our mind step by step up to this stage, we can do that. Now we cannot. But when you develop up to this stage, we can face these eight worldly conditions. See, we have reached up to that level. Started with our duties, responsibilities at home. And today we have reached Nibbana in this. This Mangala Sutta completed.